Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about scaling aspect. Okay, so scaling aspect, you can see in this, we are having a same configuration of each and every machine to just support n number of customers, increasing number of customers. We keep adding the number of instance with the same configurations, like 2-core process, 4 GB of RAM. We keep adding the same set of machines so that we can accommodate, we can satisfy the requests which are coming from multiple end users. Okay, so number of users are keep increasing, number of machines which we have in our API backend, that is also keep increasing. This is horizontal scaling. When in terms of vertical scaling, we are not increasing the number of machines, we are increasing the capacity of a single machine so that it can accommodate more processes. Okay, so we are actually increasing the RAM, increasing the memory, increasing the CPU resources of that machine, so that machine can have multi-core, maybe a 4-core, 16-core, and similarly we are increasing the memory of that machine so that it can handle the more traffic coming from the clients. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to just draw a simple architecture that how we are doing a simple scaling of application with the help of different tools. Okay, so if we talk about a scaling, and if we try to build that kind of scaling on the local system, because we have only single system, but how it works on the production, how it works on the development. So this is our end user. I will try to draw something and we'll try to explain it. So this is our user. So here we have Node.js processes. Okay, now consider that we have a 3 different microservices in the application and only single instance of each and every microservice is running. Consider that each service is of single core, 1 core, 2 GB RAM. Okay, same configuration each and every microservice is having. Now consider that our traffic for this particular set of requests keeps increasing. Then how we can achieve the scalability? If we talk in terms of horizontal scale and vertical scale, we keep adding the same instance. Okay, this is service one. Let's add one more instance of it. Let's add one more instance of it. Okay, similarly we will do, okay, this is another microservice. Let's add one more instance of it. Same thing we can do with other services, and this is how we will try to achieve the horizontal scaling of the same service. But will it be beneficial for us, or how can we make it more better? I mean, like, if we do it in the vertical scaling, then how we can achieve it? Vertical scaling means you will try to scale the resources of individual instance. Instead of creating a different system, we can actually increase the resources. We can make it as a 4-core, like there can be a 4-core, and let's put it as 8 GB. Same applies for all the other instances. Okay, like this. But are we still be able to get the advantage of this processes, because there is only single Node.js process running on the 4-core? So we will not be able to get the advantage of 4 different cores on a single system where we are running Node.js. So what we need to do, we can actually use PM2 as a process manager. I mean, there are many solutions available. PM2 can be one good solution. Okay, we can run PM2 on all the services, and PM2 will be able to scale your solution, scale your service based on number of cores you are having, like 4 cores. So you can have at least minimum 1 to 4 number of Node.js instance running on this machine. Because you have 4 cores, so you can at least utilize all different 4 cores. If you are running only a single process, then you will not be able to take the advantage of it. So what we can do is we can actually create a 4 process, and using PM2, which is a process manager, using a single command, you can actually create a 4 different instance of this Node.js process here, and they will do the internal load balancing. So if I talk about simple load balancer, I mean, I'm not talking about elastic load balancer here, but just to show how load balancing will work. Here, whenever the request is going to this, then this daemon process, which is a PM2 process, will actually do the load balancing of in between these four different instances which we have created. Okay. Otherwise, what we will do is, you have a constraint, okay, you have only one core and 2 GB RAM, and you are not running it on the PM2, because I mean, running a single instance is not helpful with the PM2. If you have a multi-core, if you want to create a multiple process, then only use PM2. So here you are running a single node. We don't have a node load balancer and all. Here we have created another instance of it. What we wanted to distribute the traffic between these two systems. In that case, it's a good advice that we should use load balancer. This is application level load balancing. Okay, here we will divert the traffic between these two instances. Okay, this is how it will work, and same thing, you can do a load, put a load balancer here in front of this also. So, and you can create a multiple instance of it. Okay, we are not using PM2 now. PM2 is helpful when you have multiple cores and you want to create a multiple instance of it. Now, same thing, you can actually, you are talking to this load balancer for another microservice request. Again, just lower it down. Okay, anyway, this is how it is going to work, and from the client you will be getting request to Nginx. Now Nginx is helping us with the API backend, right? I mean, this is just an example I wanted to talk about. So with the Nginx, you can also have like front end. There is no use case of front end scalability, because most of the time in the front end applications we are showing some static HTML files, so that you can render from the cloud front. Okay, here we have this configuration, and we are using, this can be a managed service, like you can use AWS Elastic Load Balancer, Application Load Balancer for these kind of cases. Or another use case is, you can actually create a simple Nginx which can also act as a load balancer. I mean, this is a very trivial case, but there is nothing wrong in this also. You put it like this. Okay, here you actually redirect this traffic to this particular process, and you can also have a duplicate of this. Okay, and you are talking to this service. Okay, I mean, this is how we can do the load balancing. This is just an option. At edge case, you can have a load, you can use Nginx as a load balancer also, like we were doing it earlier. Okay, or you can also use a managed services from the cloud providers like AWS and all. There also you can do the load balancing. So now we understood what is the horizontal scaling and what is the vertical scaling for our application deployments.